How many people designated drivers tonight? Oh. 3 people. 2,000 people are staring at me like, why get drunk if you ain't gonna drive? That's half the fun of being plowed. See all those headlights coming at you, trying to figure out which 2's real ones. And I'm not making fun of this program. I think it's a great idea. You know, because anything is safer than the way we used to do it. Hey, dude, get up. Give us a ride home, man. Come on, what you say? We'll buy you a beer. Come on, what's that? The only problem with a designated driver program is not the world's most desirable job. Because if you think about it, basically you're babysitting people whose biggest ambition is to pee in the parking lot. But if you ever get talked into doing it, have fun with the group. Like at the end of the night, drop them off at the wrong damn house. Preferably in their boss's front yard or something. Where the hell are my flamingos? You can make money on them. Drunks will give you money for anything. What you do, cram as many of them as you can fit into your car. On the way home, stop at every gas station you come to. Get out, pretend like you're putting gas in the car, make them pay for a full dang tank. You make $400 or $500 in a 10-mile stretch. Dang, Bill, the mileage on this thing sucks. Too many of you know what I'm talking about. Just please don't drink and drive. It's not funny. And I've known it all my life. I was a kid. I was riding on the front seat of the car with my dad, and he had been drinking beer all day, and we got pulled over by the highway patrol. And the officer walked up to my dad's window, and he went, "Excuse me there, sir. Could I see your license, please?" "No, sir, I don't need a cold beer. I don't think you do either." "Mr. Foxworthy, do you know why I pulled you over, sir?" "Well, it concerns that vehicle you're pulling behind you." "No, sir, it's not against the law to tow a boat, but we do require you put it on a trailer." "Could you ask your friends to get out of the boat, please, sir?" "No, sir, I don't give a damn if the fish are biting. Could you ask your friends to get out of the boat?" "Hey, you dropped your skier about a mile back there." So please don't drink and drive. Don't drink and hunt either. I've got a lot of relatives good at that. A few years ago, my Uncle Jack shot my cousin Ricky. Said he thought he was a deer. Poor old Rick just backing the car out of the driveway. That's what you get for driving a brown car with a white license plate and a luggage rack. Those luggage racks look just like antlers from a bathroom window. They really do. Women don't like anything from a taxidermist. Think about that. You never see deer heads in dress shops. But there's a balance here, because if there weren't women, there'd be a lot of guys with apartments full of dead stuffed animals, just showing them off to each other. "Come on in here, George, look at these. Right there's a white-tailed deer, a mallard duck, and a Siamese cat. Had run off the road to hit him, they're quick." Did somebody get upset over here? It's a joke. I have 2 cats. One on either side of the fireplace. You guys have been terrific. God bless you. Thank you for coming out. Thank you very much.